the best goal of the season. I think Vamsi, go for it. I
know you have a shot. Bro, you can't go with a Garnacho goal. Come on. I don't think I've seen a better bicycle kick in a while. Last one was Wayne Rooney. That I was like, yeah. What the fuck happened then? Dude, that so Garnacho goal, yeah, it was insane. Like the technique.
Yeah.
Dude, only a fucking 19-year-old kid can do that shit. Because you get what I mean? The ball's going away from the goal. He's just like, all right, I'm just going to get up now and do this.
I would love for something similar or like, you know, one of those bangers to be scored at Emirates, because it's been such a big, like such a while where you're like, you know, what happened? Like what happened? Like all of a sudden. But Garnacho's overhead kick or Rooney's overhead kick?
Ooh, technique wise, Garnacho's, but legendary wise, Rooney. I mean, that was against like City. This is fucking against like Everton. Like, dude, this is against an Everton even about to lose. You know what I mean?
No, I think for me, Rooney stands out because it was at OT and it was the 3-2 winner, right? And then the celebration after that, the moment, it was amazing. Like, you know, silencing the neighbors, the noisy neighbors at that point of time. So,
and the Rooney is so big, bro. Like, just his whole body weight up into the air. The whole phenomena of the physical phenomena of it was just amazing. I just loved it.
Yeah. So, Nirav, same goal, best goal of the season?
He'll pick a Howard's goal, I'm
dying. No. I mean, honestly, like, yeah, Garnacho has to be the best one here. I really like Isaac's goal too. You know, the one where he puts, like, when he takes on the left side and then puts a curler, that was a phenomenal fucking goal. Also really liked, I don't know, was it Rodri or who had, like a banger from... I can't remember exactly, but yeah, if you have to ask me, none of them come close to Garnacho's goal. It was out of this world. Like, it was just out of nowhere, out of this world, and like, you know, United needed that at that point of time. That's the only award they're going to win this year.
Favorite game? What was your favorite game of the season?
Chelsea 4, Man City 4.
There you go.
Cole Palmer. What a game.
Yeah.
Cole Palmer's final gold penalty was just amazing.
Yeah. Vamsi?
Yeah, I think that has to be... fuck you, bro. Yeah, that has to be one of the best games.
Yeah,
yeah, it was intense.
Change it. Give another one. Think of anyone.
Second best game.
For me, it's Chelsea versus Tottenham, where Tottenham completely could have been exposed, blown away. When they went down to 9-man.
What a game.
When they go to 9-man. Yeah. That was a game. That was a unique game. I don't think I like it for the quality of football, but I like it for the guts and the passion and just the way it played out.
Are you talking about that half-line defending shit?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That has to be up there, you know. Yeah, that has to be up there.
That was a nice game.
Yeah. I think... I can't those believe two. Tottenham has won the most entertaining game, despite what our manager says.
And a good shout for me, personal, Arsenal for Luton Town 3. Just personal.
Oh, yeah.
That was too good. All right, let's go.
There was a Liverpool-Luton game also. That was like that.
Because we're on Luton, let's do this one. Best last minute winner.
Declan Rice versus Luton. Because I already said that. Yeah. So yeah. Declan Rice versus Luton, best last minute winner. Declan Rice versus Man United last minute winner.
That was mine. Stole my show.
Fucker. Yeah. Just Declan Rice has just like last minute shit waiting for us. Dude, mine has to be Calvert-Lewin scoring, bro, against Liverpool. Sorry.
Pool? Against Liverpool?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was last minute,
just
right?
Just everybody standing and... Yeah, couple...
That was last minute?
It was Arsenal. Yeah, it wasn't last minute, or it was like 60th minute or something.
No, it was not last minute.
You're hearing the question still.
That was the last thing that happened in the game. After that, Sean Dyche split Dyche punch.
The game was dead. Game was over.
Yeah, game was over after that.
Okay. Best celebration of the season?
Best celebration of the season is going to be Kai Havertz.
Chelsea. Against Chelsea, right?
Against Chelsea. I'm so sorry, but that was just poetic beyond another level. Like, I just loved it. Everything about that was like...
Yeah.
Yeah. For me, my boys gave me one.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Shout out.
Yeah, United boys gave me like a really nice moment. Kobbie Mainoo, Garnacho and Højlund just all three sitting on that.
Iconic.
On that. Yeah. Just that... It's the only good moment I can remember from this fucking season. So
I literally had the same one written down, but I wanted you to say because I knew you would say it, so I was like, okay, say it. you bask in your moment of glory there.
This is Hoyland on his purple patch in between.
Yeah.
That's in the limit.
But you know what? If these three guys go on to become something, that moment would be priceless. You know, football is a game of moments, and that moment would be absolutely priceless. It'll go on so many United fans' walls that you can't even believe. So, absolutely loved it.
Dude, I know this is like not in the Premier League, but I really loved Ahmad. Like the last minute goals that you asked, it was just Ahmad's goal against Liverpool.
Yeah.
Yeah, that
last minute goal is like.
Has to go best celebration and best last minute winner as like
last minute goal. Dude, talking about last minute goals, Scott McTominay versus Brentford, if you remember.
Ooh.
97.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was
he scored two, right? He scored two in the extra time.
Yeah, exactly. So the whole combination of everything was crazy. Even Kulusevski versus Sheffield, but I'm not going to take Tottenham. Tottenham had to win that game, but that last minute goal against Sheffield was good. They were winning 1-0 and they won 2-1.